So I want to chat about something very interesting about the coronavirus. Typically, the symptoms, and there's actually quite a lot of different symptoms, but mainly you get fever, you're tired, a dry cough, shortness of breath, sore throat, your lungs start to become inflamed, and there's a series of symptoms. But recently, there's been an observation that there's an additional symptom, okay? And it's a loss of smell. The medical name for loss of smell is anosmia, okay? You can also get a loss of taste where everything just tastes like cardboard. That has been recently found to be a common symptom of the coronavirus. So the question is why? And I have some ideas. The first thing I want to tell you is that there's a certain enzyme that's involved in your perception of smell and taste. And this is the name of the enzyme, carbonic anhydrase 6. And this essential enzyme for taste and smell is zinc-dependent, okay? Now, I'm not sure that you know this, but one big symptom of a zinc deficiency is a loss of smell and a loss of taste. You can even go online and order a zinc test, which basically you take a little zinc and you put it in your mouth. And if you cannot taste anything, you're zinc deficient, because usually zinc tastes very metallic. So if you actually taste that metallic taste, you have enough zinc. If you don't taste it, you are deficient. So you can actually get that test and see for yourself. But if you do research on this symptom alone, okay, a loss of smell, it will list a series of causes. And I want to go through them and I want to show you how many of them are related and connected to zinc. Because I really think the reason for this symptom is a zinc deficiency for a couple reasons. One is that when you go through an infection, especially in your lungs, you use up a lot of zinc. Zinc is not stored that well. So unless you're constantly consuming zinc, chances are you're gonna be deficient. On top of that, if you get this infection, you're gonna be even more deficient. And zinc has a huge purpose of protecting you against microbes and especially viruses. It's a really key immune protector for the immune system. So let's take a look at the causes of loss of smell. First of all, we have upper respiratory infection. We already know that 16% of pneumonia cases are actually caused by a zinc deficiency, okay? So there's definitely that relationship. Nasal polyps. Next one, idiopathic hypogonadotropic hypogonadism. Now, say that three times real fast. Basically, the testicles are shrinking, and idiopathic means we don't know why, okay? Unknown cause. Well, guess what? Zinc deficiency will cause hypogonadism, as well as low testosterone. Next one, hypothyroidism, antibiotics, diabetes. High levels of sugar in the blood will deplete zinc, FYI. Cushing syndrome. This is a condition where you have high cortisol and or stress will deplete zinc. And then we have the next one, cadmium poisoning, cadmium. Cadmium is a toxic heavy metal that will definitely deplete zinc. So that's probably why you have a loss of smell, because the cadmium depletes zinc. And then you have this next one, which I already told you, a zinc deficiency. So loss of smell could be caused by a zinc deficiency. Here's the next one, Kallmann syndrome. What is this? This is a genetic condition where you have hypogonadism. Then we have this last one, primary ciliary dyskinesia. Now, what the heck is that? And this just means a genetic disorder involving a dysfunction of your sperm. Well, guess what? Sperm is highly influenced by the amount of zinc in your body. So what can we learn from this information? Well, the loss of smell potentially could be a zinc deficiency. And if you take zinc, not only will you be able to improve the sense of smell, but you will also increase the strength of the immune system. So what can someone take away from this information? Well, just the importance of zinc and how vitally important it is, not just for smell, but to protect your immune system, to decrease the duration where someone is going through an infection. And the fact that when someone has an infection, they're probably already deficient. So if you haven't seen my video on boosting the immune system, check it out. I put it right here.